Hi, and welcome to my channel. This is DIY with Jeannie, and we do all things crafting. If you've been with us before, welcome back. And if you are new and like crafting, then please consider subscribing and hitting that like button. And come back each time that we do this. My goal this year is to have 1,000 viewers by the end of the year. Lofty, I realize, and I'm going to have to get a little bit better about being regular to do this. But what I wanted to do today is go over how to make these little bows with the Cricut Joy. Would you stop? I'm not making this one today, but I did make this one with the Joy. And I just glued it together, and then it can be put onto a barrette or however you want to use it. But today we're going to make just a regular one bow with the back. For just a small bow to show you. Now, if you like this content, I would greatly appreciate your giving me a thumbs up and subscribing so that you're notified and hitting that bell so you're notified every time I do put in new content. Now, what I have here is vinyl that I use to make vinyl bags. I line it and I sew this and make vinyl bags out of it. But it'll be good for this as well, and your Cricut Joy will cut it using just the signature blade that comes with the Cricut Joy. So I tape it along the edges because it likes to pull up along the edges, and we don't want it to pull up while it's in the machine. And these are the pieces we're going to cut out and put our bow together. So we're going to just hit make it. It lined it up for us. We're on the long one. Should work. Next, we're waiting on it to remember it's the Joy. So you've got a mood bag. There it is. Pick our Joy. And next, we don't need the mirror on this one. It is three very simple pieces. I don't know if you can see them really well. But they are just the bow parts and this thing in the back. And then the piece to wrap around the center. So, I don't know if this is going to work. It's 21 and a half inches long. Okay, let's go back. Okay, we're going to do it this way. Make it go away. Come back. Get up to my projects. Pick our bow. Customize. Let's make it a little smaller. Keep that. And I want to take these and make them smaller. So, same pieces. You can see them now better on this. And let's make it. Alright. Okay. Next. Go think about what it's doing. She's decided she wants to be with us. So let's go in here, and we're going to pick faux leather. So paper thin faux leather, and I want extra pressure, so more pressure. Okay. And everything ready. So now we're going to hopefully get around the cap. There we go. And let it start. That's good. Give us our go here in a minute. So that's two pieces, and I think I've got enough. So we'll go, and I'll show you how I set it up when I pull for the next one. And let's wait and let it do its thing. going to cut both of them twice so that we get it nice and cut out. Because that is the one thing that you don't want to do is take it out without it being cut. Yes, I did. Okay. So, we're going to unload. Take this off. We have to use the tape again for our second piece. Because we have to do the same thing all over again for the second part of our bow. Let's cut that down the edge. So, it's okay. And off of there. I'm hoping I can just pull it off like so. Like that. We just want it up so I can put my next piece on. That piece up, get this one up. Now this one I'm gonna have to move because my next piece is much thinner. Go out. Get my next piece. Get on. This one tacked down on that side. Put that tape on the opposite side. Tacked it down. And then on top again. And again, if we cut, then we just pull it off there. It comes right off the line. So, still want material or leather. Pressure more. Okay, there we go. All right. So we've so far got these two pieces. We're just waiting on our last piece. Let's go. Under the base. Not quite wide enough, but it'll be fine. Okay. Okay, with unloading. Take it out. Out of the way. Let's take it off. There is our fishtail part of our bow. This one's much, much larger. We can make it a lot smaller. We could make it bigger. And I kind of like that it's big for us this time. There we go. Now, the way we put it together, I use glue. I'm just using the Obsidy Craft Glue, non-toxic. It's just your random glue. I love reptile glue. It used to be to retile. People used it. Let's put this out. Middle here. And take down the top. And then we take our last piece and put glue on the whole thing. Didn't need quite that much, but it's fine. Lay it down on the top. top. Wrap it around. And there we go. I'm going to take one of my little clips and clip it so that it will dry. And there is our bow. And we were able to do it with our Cricut Joy. So don't think that just because you don't have the big Cricut machine, you can't do all of the projects. Because you can. You just have to sometimes make them a little bit smaller, be a little more creative in the way you set them up. And you can do most of the jobs that you can do with the big one with our little workhorse, the Joy. So there is that bow we just made together. And here is the mermaid bow that I made last night. And there is more to this bow. I could then, I could make two of those, put a butterfly behind. There are lots of different patterns, and they are available online. A lot of places have free patterns. So I get mine at Creative Fabrica. I'll link it at the bottom. But this is just one more thing that you can do with a little Cricut Joy, and this is about half the price of the big machines. So if you just want to get started and you don't want to invest that $300-something, look for a Cricut Joy. I think you'll enjoy it, and we will do more next time. I've got keychains and more to make with you. So that is our video for today. I hope you liked it. If you did, consider subscribing, hit the like button, leave me a comment. Do you like the idea of the bow? Would you, it's the same whether I do multiple pieces or not. It's all exactly the same process. But I might do them in different colors to make the top part stand out a little bit better. But that's what we have today, and I appreciate your time. You can spend time with anyone, and I'm thankful that you spent it with me. Have a wonderful week.